You all asked for it, and now you're going to get it. Hello, everyone. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Ultimate Doom Xbox Live Arcade Version. Now, before we go anywhere, a couple things I'd like to say. In one of my most recent channel updates, I mentioned continuing this game because, as I'm sure a lot of you know, I actually had to stop this LP. The last time I updated it was in December of 2011, and it was due to problems with my original Xbox Live account, which prevented me from playing this game. And I was finally able to get this game for my new Xbox Live account because Microsoft actually put it back on the Xbox Live Marketplace after taking it down for a few months. And in my most recent channel update, or next to most recent, I actually released a poll saying, asking my viewers and subscribers if they wanted to see me continue this game, and it was a pretty unanimous response. And well, be careful what you wish for, because now you have it. Let's Play Ultimate Doom is back. Now, in the last episode, which was released back in December of 2011, almost, like, what, 10 months ago, we had actually finished episode 3 for Ultimate Doom, which was Inferno, where we defeated the Spider Demon boss, and In the original version of Doom, that was the end of the game. But in Ultimate Doom, they added an extra episode that we are going to be tackling for the remainder of this project. So, new game. And episode 4 for Doom is I Flesh Consumed. And this is considered to be one of the hardest episodes, perhaps the hardest episode in the entire Ultimate Doom game. The levels are said to be extremely hard, or maybe not extremely hard, but much harder than any of the levels that came before them. They are so hard, in fact, for me anyway, I am changing my rules for this episode. I did the previous three episodes on Ultra Violence, but I will be going down one difficulty level because, yeah, they really are that hard on Ultra Violence, and because I don't want to give myself a stroke while trying to beat this game, I am lowering the level of difficulty to hurt me plenty. So yeah, that should give you an idea of how hard the levels are that we're about to tackle, at least for me. So enough talk, it's time to start off with Thy Flesh Consumed and finally continue this LP and hopefully be able to finish it. Let's go! Alright. Now, I talked about the levels in this chapter being hard. Ironically, this first level is actually one of the hardest. One of the hardest. It's actually considered one of the most difficult levels in the entire Doom game. Welcome to Hell Beneath. Now, once you pick up that shotgun, get ready to fight, because these zombies are going to start teleporting in. That's a major factor in why this level is so hard, because periodically enemies will teleport from seemingly out of nowhere to fight you. And it's so bad that in areas where you think you've actually cleared the level of enemies, all of a sudden a bunch of enemies will spawn. And it's going to happen multiple times. And all I'm going to say about this level is, if you're the type of player that likes to run in guns blazing, you'd better change that strategy for this level if you want to survive. Now, let's see. There's actually a secret that we can access right away, but we have to go into that pool of toxic liquid. Okay, we got through that. Now, here are two teleporters. Doesn't really matter which one you take. You go to the same general area. And I believe I just heard a teleporter noise. Yep. Sure enough, there's an imp. Now, part of what makes this level so hard on Ultra Violence is that you see these med kits here? They are not there on Ultra Violence. None of the med kits in this level are present. So, yeah. That's one reason I didn't do this on Ultra Violence, because, you know, I didn't want to have to try and play through a level with so few health power-ups. And now we got more monsters teleporting in. So, on Ultra Violence, this is considered one of the hardest levels in the game. This game, the entire episode for All Thy Flesh Consumed isn't known for being easy. Nor should it be, considering it's the last chapter before beating the whole game. Now see these health bonuses? These five health bonuses, and there are five others on the other side of this room. These are the only health items in the entire level on Ultra Violence. Yeah. This level doesn't pull any punches, I'm telling you that right now. But get ready for a struggle. I'm telling you, I could not beat this level when I tried to beat it on, when I first tried to finish this Let's Play on Ultra Violence, I could not get through this level. So yeah, I did have to... I mean, I didn't want to lower the difficulty. I would love to be able to beat the rest of the game on Ultra Violence, but I'm not going to put myself through that. Now we got a Baron of Hell. Whoa! Hey, 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 hey! Hey, hey, where's your manners? Get out of my face! See what I said about the teleporting monsters? These monsters all teleported in. Because this room was clear about 2 minutes ago. Now, here's an interesting tidbit about the Thy Flesh Consumed levels. In addition to being more difficult than the average level, as I've pretty much harped on for the past 6 or 7 minutes, every level in this game, with the exception of the secret level, is named after a biblical verse. So every level name, the title of every level references the Bible. Which is pretty interesting. Pretty interesting if you ask me. Alrighty. Now we're gonna have to go into that room eventually. Heck, we're gonna go in there right now. Go, 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 go. More monsters are gonna spawn. So you can see, take a look at the damage I've taken. And that's with being able to grab health packs. Like, I would not be able to do this on Ultra Violence. I'm sorry to say that. It really is that difficult. Let's see. Let's grab one med kit. Because we're probably gonna need the other one. Oh, and another thing about this level and whatnot, this whole episode I'm going to be doing, expect to see me save a lot. That's all I'm going to say. I'm going to be saving a lot, probably, because I don't want to have to restart the whole level if something bad happens. Okay. Now this room, we got to go behind that wall to get another skull key to finish the level. Whoa. Grab the skull key and run. Seriously, you're gonna be doing a lot of backpedaling and whatnot in this level, and you have to really watch your back. Now there's actually a secret in this room. What we have to do is, and I am going to save, in case something bad happens. We want to go up to this porch, and it's actually a switch that'll activate a secret. And it'll also release Barons of Hell. Go, 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 go. Now, in case you didn't get a good look at it, that's actually an Easter egg. You probably noticed that that those letters on the screen, on the ceiling, looked like the logo for the band Nine Inch Nails. Pretty cool. Because I think Trent Reznor, the front man for Nine Inch Nails or whatever, had something to do with the music. I know he had something to do with the soundtrack for Doom 3, or at least the opening theme, but I don't really know. But I thought that was a pretty cool Easter egg. Too bad we didn't get that good of a look at it, because I had to get out of that room in a hurry. Right. Oh my god, they're blocking my path. Yeah, I'm dead. No question, I'm not gonna make it. Just get... I'm in a bad spot. I had to reload right there. I was gonna die. I didn't have enough ammo to kill all of them anyway. I mean, forget the health. Okay. Get the... Oh my goodness gracious. Get... No, get out of my way. Oh, man. Okay, so I activated that secret just so I'd get credit for it. Let's get out of here. The exit is right here. I am not sticking around. I think I've seen enough of this level. This is probably the one level I'm not going to get 100% of anything on, because quite frankly, I don't have the ammo to kill all those enemies, and I don't have the health to endure all of them. So you know what? We're just going to have to get out of here. Huh, man. Look at that. All that, and the only 100% that I got was items. Pretty sad. But if you thought Hell Beneath was rough, and I know it didn't look like it, but trust me, it is. If you thought that level was crazy, wait till you see the next one. Perfect Hatred. Look what we gotta deal with right off the bat. Monsters everywhere with almost no cover. This is the craziest level yet, and this one is also very difficult. Heck, even on Hurt Me Plenty, this level is hard. Especially if you're new to it, which is the case for every level. And look, we got Caco Demons for the first time. I'm not holding anything back on these guys. It's rocket time. Alright, took care of those guys. So yeah, the first two levels in Thy Flesh Consumed can be very, very difficult. Okay, let's see. We don't want to go that way. Now, eventually, the way this level works is we're going to be picking up key cards to open different paths. And ultimately, we want to go to that area at the top where all those demons are running around. But we're going to cross that bridge when we come to it. Let's pick off some enemies in this area and try to make our job a little bit easier. Because once we go into this whole building here, we're going to be dealing with a lot of monsters. And this is probably going to be the last level I do for this video. I'm going to be aiming for about 2 levels per episode, and I'm not going to worry about how long the video is. Since you know, I don't have to worry about a time limit anymore. I'm just gonna, you know, however long it takes me to get through 2 levels, that's how long the video is gonna be. Gonna drop this Baron of Hell right here. So yeah, I don't know what the other secret is for Hell Beneath, and it's probably not worth trying to find out. So yeah. I'm still going to be aiming for 100% kills. It's just that it's really hard to get that for Hell Beneath just because of the sheer number of monsters and there's not that much ammo. Wow, that thing is... Man, those things are... Yes, I blew up a zombie with a rocket. Nothing wrong with overkill. Now, you gotta be careful when going across these platforms. because there's lava on the floor, and, well, you know what happens when Doom Guy lands in lava. Bad stuff happens. Now you all kill yourselves. Watch my back, make sure I don't get ambushed. Let's see, go! Okay. Radiation shielding suit. I'm not sure how this is supposed to protect me from lava, but we'll go with it. Like, really, how is this supposed to protect me from lava? I mean, the radioactive liquid and whatnot, I can understand. But lava? That's a stretch. But then again, I don't think anybody ever praised Doom for being realistic. Okay. That's right, the wall behind us opens up when we take that teleporter. And imps are gonna come out. Now, as you probably noticed, in this lava room, I actually opened a secret. Oh, not a secret, but I actually activated a path to get to a platform. We actually have to get to that platform to get a skull key. Unfortunately, we got Barons of Hell to deal with, and I just got destroyed almost. Look, there are three Barons of Hell in that room that we have to kill. Nothing that a little plasma gun can't fix, I guess. I love the plasma gun. Ouchcha! Oh no, this is not good. Oh, I just screwed myself by not... Oh boy. Let this be a lesson to conserve your health, ladies and gentlemen. Get the health, or get the mega armor, like it's really gonna do me any good. Please let there be a health pack. Thank you! Oh man, this level. Die! Is that even touching him? I can't even be sure if that's even hitting. Am I even hitting those guys? Yes, I am. Gotcha. All right, there's just one more left. Give me that health. Die. Die. Thank you. Okay, that's taken care of. Man, this level. This whole episode, man. This whole chapter, I can't say it enough. They really did not pull any punches when it came to episode 4. Get the radiation suit. Again, I'm not sure how this is supposed to protect me from molten lava, but I'm not gonna debate the game's logic. When you try to debate video game logic, you usually lose. Are those Barons of Hell attacking the, lost souls? Yeah, it wouldn't be Doom without these guys. Now, an interesting thing about Thy Flesh Consumed is, what's kind of interesting is how this episode, this set of levels, fits in with the Doom storyline. It's unknown when exactly this takes place in relation to the other games in the Doom series. Obviously, it takes place after the events of Doom 1, but it has to also be before the events of Doom 2. Yeah. Bit of a mind screw. It's not completely clear where these levels are in the timeline. Then again, I don't think Doom really cares about plot or timelines anyway. I mean, it's a freaking game about can demons with assault weapons? Come on. Okay, shotgun shells. Now that platform with all those demons, we're going to be getting up there very soon. But they're not alone up there. You can probably see him walking around in the background. I'm just going to go ahead and tell everybody right now, there's a cyber demon up there. That's right, a cyber demon. But there's a very easy way to kill him. You know, without going through all the BS of, you know, shooting him with rockets and whatnot. Come out, you stupid caco demon. I know you're in there. The caco demon couldn't come out of his hole at first. Yeah, come on down to my level. Now, this room. Let's see, save this. Now, it's actually very easy to die in this room because you can easily get overwhelmed by enemies. There are a lot of specters in this room. Hey, come here. Come here. You know, chainsaw.
It's good for you.
It's so good, it'll kill you. Eh, whatever. Oh, snap. Come on out, caco demon. I know you're here. I'm gonna kill the specters with the chainsaw, and I'm gonna kill the caco demons from a distance. See, the caco demons, man, they can really screw you if you don't watch it. Especially in a level like this. Okay, so much for what I said. I kept saying I was gonna kill the specters with the chainsaw. Haven't been doing that. Oh no, I'm not getting... Lure the specter away from the caco demon so I don't get hurt by the caco demon while I'm killing the specter. Hey, don't float away from me. I'm talking to you, buddy. I'm not done with you. Okay, that should be everyone in this room. Oh god, lost souls again. I hate lost souls, man. They're my least they are easily my least favorite enemy. And it doesn't help there's a whole bunch of them at the top of this staircase. Light them up with the plasma beam, though, and everything is taken care of. But guess who's over there? Baron of Hell! Wow, he actually used a teleporter? That never happened in the practice run. In all my practice runs of this level, that never happened. Oh, what do I do here? If I go through it, he's gonna be right there to kill me. Let's save. I mean, look at my health. Aha! Thought you were smart, weren't you? Trying to use the teleporter. Whatever, dude. Get my shotgun. Now, like I said, there's a really cheap and easy way to deal with that cyber demon. Drop down here, get a supercharge, and run. Okay, I didn't lose too much health off of that. Now, an interesting thing about this level is that this level has a secret exit. And if you've been following this LP, even though I haven't updated it in a very long time, I always go for the secret exit. Because I am going to try and show every single level in the game. And I just fell off again. Jeez, I'm not going to have any health by the time I get done with this thing. Come on. Enough screwing around. Let's go. Okay, I'm gonna kill all these guys before I head up to the platform. You know, take care of the problem before it becomes a bigger problem. That cyber demon's bad enough. Alright. Well, hello, Mr. Cyber Demon. Pleased to make your acquaintance. Oh my goodness. Hey, there's the teleporter. So that teleporter, watch what it does. Once I activate it. Go into here and... yes! We teleported into the Cyber Demon and killed him. And we got the BFG, the most powerful weapon in the game. So yeah, that's an easy way to deal with the Cyber Demon. I didn't even have to fire a shot. And when I first saw that happen, I was like, whoa, awesome. That makes life a lot easier. Too bad it doesn't do anything about these Caco demons. Whoa. Idiot, he floated right into it. Oh yes, I love the rocket launcher. Unless I shoot it too close to an enemy, but that's another story. Okay. Get some health. Okay. Do not activate that switch because that will cause us to exit the level. We don't want that. So yeah, you can see the bloody remains of the Cyber Demon. Now, the secret exit is right here, but we have to open a wall. And that wall is opened by taking that teleporter that we took to kill the Cyber Demon. So let's be quick about this. Wait a minute. Actually, let me grab that shotgun ammo. And then... we'll grab the, get a health pack. Mega armor. Or just armor. That's it, I'm done talking. Let's go. Whew. Yeah, that door closes very quickly, so you gotta be ready. Alrighty then. It's time to leave. Perfect hatred finished. ...100% of everything. You gotta love it. It took 15 minutes. Oh well. And we are entering fear. And pause. Because we're gonna cut it here. So that is a wrap on this episode of Let's Play Ultimate Doom Xbox Live Arcade version. This Let's Play is back from the dead. I'm glad to finally be able to get this project going again. And if you folks liked what you saw in this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. This is Ultimate Life from RB signing out for now, and I will see all of you in the next episode as we take on Thy Flesh Consumes Secret Level Fear. See you then.